Hello, my name is Lao Ngai Yuen, or Yuen, call me short, and I'm the founder president of Women Girls. I run a couple of NGOs as well, but right now my biggest project to date is to run a huge technology festival in Penang. One of the things that I thought I knew, but I didn't know, is the real meaning of negotiation. Negotiation is your entire life, not just this one time. You negotiate all the time, from when you're young, go to the washroom, and then the teacher will have an opportunity or have a chance, a 50% chance to say no. And then you either get really upset or you start crying because you feel like you're victimized, like, cikgu tak bagi pergi tandas, you cry, you know. Or you choose, lah cikgu cepat je, saya perlukan 2 minit je, saya lari lepas tu saya balik sini. Ataupun saya habis tulis ni lepas tu saya pergi. So if you think or if you put your mindset as understanding life is a constant negotiation, that every single no is an opportunity for you to explain yourself better and an opportunity for you to look at things from a different point of view, then your chances of winning the negotiation is way higher. Now when I say win, what is the win, right? The fact that you go to the toilet, how is that a win? But the win here is in understanding how to phrase this better for the other person to understand your needs. And also the win is understanding what the other person needs. So if you didn't understand what the other person needs, then you will never go anywhere in your conversation, in your negotiation. So the idea here is the win needs to be looked at as, oh, now you faham. That's the win. If you drive alone and you have the music on all the time, then you will not notice the little voice in your head. But if you switch off your radio and you drive, 5 minutes later, that voice will be so loud, there's no switch button to switch it off. It's also very interesting sometimes to take a listen to what this voice is actually telling you, because without us realizing, this low voice has been there all the time and is speaking to us all the time, especially in moments where we are, our own thoughts are weakened, or we are shocked, or we are in disbelief when somebody does some injustice to us, for example. This little voice will be very loud. So if you don't spend enough time understanding where this little voice comes from and what experience gave this little voice, you know, that kind of conviction and where I'm coming from, etc., etc., then you will realize that when things don't go your way and you're upset or you're in doubt or you are low in that moment, this voice will overpower and tell you things that can be very far from truth, because it's just trying to get us back to, don't worry about this, let's be comfortable. Therefore, what you feed the voice and how you speak to the voice yourself is also very important. If your voice has always been exposed to how you react to failures, then it will immediately kick in and tell you, I told you so, so that you can accept defeat and stay home. Stay in bed, be safe. And don't have to be exposed to all this danger or challenges. But if you tell yourself enough times, hey, look, I know I didn't win this, but this is what I like. I like to be challenged like this. I want to be challenged like this. So this is great. Let me try this again. You tell your little voice that again and again and again and again. It will get used to what you say. One day it will say, it's okay, you've gone through worse, this is nothing. Because then this, your little voice now understands, this is your comfort. Your comfort is that you want to push yourself and you're comfortable wanting to push yourself. But if you don't have this conversation, you don't challenge your little voice enough, the perception or the experience that you're exposed to is very limited. So you do need to like, but look at that person, look at this person I just met. So networking is very important. And how this person reacts to this particular scenario. I gotta learn that because I've never seen that. Huh? Little voice, take note, please take note. So you kind of have to have that all the time. And if you don't network or you don't have huge community support behind you, I can tell you for sure that you won't have enough references and that it will be difficult for you to overcome perception because you cannot fight it. So you kind of have to be able to say, look at how that person is doing. Or I need help. I need help. Can someone help me because I'm facing this? My brain is telling me this and I know there must be another way. No one ever is alone. You just need to reach out and we'll reply. Yes, of course, we'll do it for you. And that's usually what we'll say.